so unlike me to forget my gloves. I was just so crazy, you know, and I...
I'm not letting you go. I'm keeping my hands warm.
I better turn on the light.
No, no, don't.
I won't be able to see where I'm going.
Just leave it. We'll trip over the furniture together.
Okay.
This is your apartment. You lead the way.
Thank God no one was on the elevator with us.
Yeah. Why do you suppose we're whispering?
I don't know.
Was supposed to leave, what, 2 hours ago?
Change of plans. I'm not going to Florida after all.
Well, you still look like a happy man. That can only mean one thing. Who is she? Anybody I know?
Could I use the cabin tonight?
What, you want to rough it with the boys?
Not exactly. I need to get away for a little while, and I thought with the cabin being so close, I could just, you know, zip up in the car and still be close if there was any kind of an emergency.
Sure.
Thank you. I can tell you how much this means to me.
No problem.
But wait, there's one other little problem. It's Jake. He's turned into Mr. Budinsky lately, and if he knows where I am, then he'll follow me, and I just won't have any peace at all, so please just don't tell Jake.
What's a big secret this time, Vicky?
Better protection. They're the smart idea on Always with Wings, and they're pretty amazing. Channels that form a barrier of protection at the edges. Even when I move, they help keep moisture in the center, so the sides get better protection. While dryweave helps keep the surface drier. They call them channels. I call it just plain smart. It protects me better than any regular maxi I've tried. New Always with Channels. It's cleaner, it's drier, and now it protects even better.
Hi, you remember me?
Oh, yeah.
I bought this sweater, and it got these ugly fuzz balls.
Man, it faded.
Yeah.
I'm sorry about that. How'd you wash it?
A gentle cycle with my usual detergent.
Right cycle, wrong detergent. Try Ivory Snow.
Really?
Ivory Snow Powder's Baby Gentle Formula cleans safely. It helps prevent fuzz or fading on cottons better than leading regular detergents.
Thanks. Oh, forget something? Never.
Ivory Snow. Save care for the things you wear.
Jesse, you're next.
I'm all yours.
Save it for the stage, Romeo.
Carol always gives it to me straight. Like when she told me about my...
I told him about Head and Shoulders. Regular shampoos just rinse flakes away so they could come back. Head and Shoulders helps prevent flakes from even forming. You see the difference? You look great.
Thanks, but will it get me this part?
Couldn't hurt.
Head and Shoulders, because great hair can't have flakes.
Hey, break a leg.
Well, come on.
Oh, do you think it's possible after all these years?
I'm pretty sure.
Oh, Albert, it's changing color.
I knew it.
We've got hard water.
If your soap won't lather well, and if your skin feels dry, you might have hard water. And then you need Zest. So call 1-800-HARD-WATER for your free Zest test kit. If the test strip changes, change to Zest.
You're not fully clean.
And smooth.
Unless you're Zest fully clean.
We're not getting older.
You're getting smoother.
chops tough or dry? Then get Shake and Bake. Chops are always plump and juicy, the way your family thinks they should be. It's simple. They want Shake and Bake.
Any air freshener can freshen a small room, but what about a large room?
Plug it in, plug it in.
New Glade plug-ins for large rooms warms two cartridges for large room freshness.
Plug it in, plug it in.
Plug into large room freshness from Glade.
I thought this vacation was for your son. Now you're telling me you're seeing Vicki Hudson?
Is that shocking?
Grant, her fiancé's only been gone a few months. Are you sure the two of you are on the same wavelength?
Now, Gabe, I realize it seems soon, but circumstances have dictated we spend some time together. First, Victoria had a terrible case of the flu, so she and the boys needed me, and Stephen's been difficult since Ryan died, full of anger, directing it at his mother. Fortunately, he responds to me, trust me.
Does Vicki?
What a question. Don't be silly.
I was always under the impression that the two of you weren't very close.
Well, it wasn't always like that. Gabe, we were in love once. I mean, she chose me over Ryan. Unfortunately, our marriage ended disastrously.
And very publicly, too, as I recall.
You know, I kissed her last week.
Ah. You get a slap in the face?
Oh, come on. It was spontaneous, like a good kiss should be. Of course, it may have had something to do with the fact that I just saved her life.
Yeah, well, she was grateful.
I think it was more than that. What are you trying to do? Are you trying to run on my parade?
No, no. Look, as your friend, I just want to make sure that you're being honest with yourself. Come on, Grant, you don't need another failed relationship.
Well, neither does she. No. Victoria deserves to find happiness.
You are really impossible to throw a surprise party for, you know that?
Oh, that's great, because it's not my birthday.
Oh, come on, Jake. There are other things in life to celebrate.
Listen to Vicki, when I told people to congratulate me, I was just joking, okay?
Okay, why? Did you win a prize or something?
I got a big prize. As a matter of fact, last night I sat and celebrated with an open bottle of bubbly, the passing of my marriage.
I'm sorry.
Whoopee, right?
Can't wait to get my annulment.
That's a nice thing to say.
Listen, I can't help it. If I never see Donna again, it'll be too soon.
Wait a minute now. I know that my mother did a rotten thing, but she's my mother. She feels miserable about it, and I'm not going to stand here listening to you trash her. And as for you, I'm very sorry. I know how much you love Paulina.
Finally, they can get married. I mean, she's having his baby. They're in love. They're perfect together. I mean, can you blame them for wanting to make it official, Jake?
You're gonna get through this, you know that?
Because you're gonna take me to dinner night, like a best friend would, right?
Jake, I can't do that tonight.
I need you.
I need you,
so Vicki.
I'm sorry. I can't do that tonight. I promise. I will make it up to you. I promise. Matthew, could I talk to you for one more second about that, about the memorial service?
Yeah, sure.
Jake?
Blair, you didn't overhear what Vicki and Matt were talking about by any chance, did you?
If I had, I wouldn't tell you, Jake. I'm not into spying on people, especially when one of them is my boss. Okay, so I need the key. To the cabin, I need the key.
I don't have them. They're at home. Donna has a key. Get it from her.
No, that means I'll have to stand around and listen to how much she misses you. Please,
Matthew. Best I can do. Just go to the cabin. When you're done, mail me the keys. Bring them by. Right. Do not give them back
to
Donna,
thanks.
Okay?
Thank you so much.
Go. Oh. Why don't you put an ad in the classified, Jake? Unreliable, untrustworthy male seeks untrue love. Sure, you'll get a lot of responses. That way, people will know what they're getting themselves into.
I'm doing fine with this investigation on my own, Lieutenant.
Wait a minute, Josie, wait.
Yeah. I don't know what kind of game you think you're playing here, Gary, but you can damn well do it without me.
Well, Officer Watts.
What?
Don't make me put you on report.
Fine. Go ahead. Then I can file a complaint against you for fraternizing against regulations, then deciding to go public with it without my consent. You see, what happened, Gary, is that it's no longer our secret. Now the whole precinct knows that you dumped me.
I didn't want it to go down like this,
Joe. First you say that you love me, you want to tell everybody,
I know,
and
okay,
then you
I was
break
out
up
of
with
line,
me and you
right?
won't even tell
look,
me
look,
why.
Look, why can't you just leave it alone?
I wish to hell you would have left me alone.
Have we run into a snag, officers?
No, I'm just due for a coffee break. If that's all right with you, Lieutenant.
She seems upset. Does it have something to do with the plug-pulling case?
No, ma'am.
Sounded personal.
Yeah, well, it wasn't personal, Lorna, all right? Officer Watts and I are handling this case very professionally, thank you.
Well, in that case, Lieutenant, do you have any leads?
No, ma'am, we have nothing. Nothing.
Now you can feel good about giving them pizza whenever they want.
Pizza in the morning, pizza in the evening, pizza at supper time. When pizza's on a bagel, you can eat pizza anytime.
Pizza Bagel Bites. Bite-sized pizzas on wholesome little bagels.
Hey, pizza at no time, pizza at school time, pizza by the two is so fine. When pizza's on a bagel, you can eat pizza anytime.
Pizza Bagel Bites. Pizza whenever you want it.
Stylists already know how great Tresemme is, but do you?
These are professional products. They give you salon beautiful hair, but without the salon price.
You are going to love Tresemme's one-of-a-kind re-moisturizing conditioner with a special blend of almond oil, silk protein, and rich emollients.
Conditions your hair beautifully.
It gives it softness and shine.
You get salon in the bottle, but not in the price.
Professional, affordable Tresemme.
5 ounces of milk make every 3/4 ounce Kraft single taste better. How do they do that?
See? They take the slice and make it into a rocket. Then they shoot it to the Milky Way. And when it gets back, it's busting with milk.
More milk means better taste. And every 3/4 ounce Kraft single is made from 5 ounces of milk. Unlike imitation cheese made mostly with oil and water.
It looks like the moon.
Milk makes Kraft singles taste better.
K-R-A-F-T. Want me to tell it again?
Warning. Experts predict the worst cold and flu season in years. Just in time, Theraflu. Hot liquid relief. When it's got to work, it's got to be Theraflu.
From Eureka Technology, the Victory Clean Air System. For powerful cleaning above the floor and on carpets. It's on the sleek Powerline and Faster Cleaning Powerline Plus. With state-of-the-art design that reduces bending. Powerline, Powerline Plus. Only from Eureka.
Tonight, it's an all-new Friends like you've never seen.
Yes!
First, a surprise wedding.
What?
And who's Rachel's mom? It's Marlo Thomas, who thinks she's Rachel.
She wants to be more like you. Couldn't she have just copied my haircut?
And get this, Joey's a doctor on Days of Our Lives.
Your sister is suffering from a...
Plus, an all-new single guy. And right after Seinfeld, a special night of Mad About You, plus ER, tonight.
I was in the first grade, so that would make me, what, six?
Six?
Yeah.
You were 6 years old when you had your first crush?
Yeah.
Really?
Girls are more advanced than boys.
Well, I guess yeah. So. Water crackers, huh?
Mm-hmm.
What does that mean, water crackers?
I hope it means they're not fattening.
Mm. What was his name?
Who?
The boy you had a crush on.
Oh, Wayne.
Wayne.
He had over 100 freckles on his face.
How do you know that?
Because I sat right next to him and I counted them when he wasn't looking. He actually walked me home from school once. I don't really remember why.
He had a crush on you.
No, he didn't.
He walked you home from school. He had a crush on you. Walking home from school is crush stuff.
You really think he did?
Mm-hmm.
I never really thought about that. I guess we were both shy.
Well, it's all in the timing.
Maybe I should give old Wayne a call. See what he's doing these days, huh?
Yeah, maybe you should. I'm sure that Wayne is probably sitting somewhere on someone's carpet in their living room dropping water cracker crumbs all over the place.
So, what about you? When did you have your first crush?
My first crush, I was... 12. I was 12 years old. Yep.
You were already tall, I bet.
Yeah, I was. Actually, I kind of felt like King Kong. That's why I went into basketball.
A jock?
Yes, I was. I was good.
That was good. I mean, there was an outside chance, but there was a chance that I could have gone pro. Of course, if I'd done that, I would never have become a doctor.
You know that I've never really been to a professional basketball game?
You're kidding.
No.
Well, you haven't lived.
Yeah, I see that.
I think the most thrilling thing to me is still just being out there on the court. You know, when I was playing, slam dunk hadn't even been invented. But it's such an adrenaline rush. Your team has the ball, the clock is running out.
I guess I've really been missing something all these years.
I haven't been to a game in a long time.
No.
The next time the Bulls play the Pacers.
You're on.
All right.
Do you think you'd really choose basketball over medicine?
Well, who knows? I mean, if I'd gotten an athletic scholarship, perhaps, or if I hadn't gone to Vietnam. I guess that medicine is really in my blood, though. It's probably what I would have done. But who knows? I mean, I might have been just as happy playing for the Big Ten, getting drafted by the NBA, having hordes of screaming fans were adoring me. Or maybe just coaching high school basketball. Who knows?
I guess we can't ever go back, can we? Just have to go on from where we are right now. I don't think I'll go away.
Are you sure?
Yeah. Freckles aren't really my thing anymore.
I missed you, my friend.
I missed you.
Riley, all right, Riley, be good, or else Aunt Vicky's not going to let us stay.
No, no, it's okay. Right? I don't need you to babysit tonight. Really, I don't.
I meant stay as in move in.
What?
Vicky, if I have to spend one more night under Michael's roof, I am going to go insane.
No,
I'm probably...
No, no, if the two of you are having trouble, work it out.
You don't understand what it's like having him nose around in my business 24 hours.
I do understand. I know Michael's routines better than anyone. Let me tell you, his heart is in the right place. It's just when you need him, he's gone.
God, I wish he was gone. Guy's all over me like a cheap suit. Now he went ballistic because I'm working for Jake.
Nick, I saw this coming. I'm not going to have Dad mad at me because I'm harboring a fugitive.
No, I'm officially off probation. I can live wherever I want.
Well, good. Good. Because, see, I have two boys, and they're a handful, right? And I have a dog. Riley, get down.
Please, Vicky, please. I'm begging you. Ask me anything, I'll do it.
No,
You want me to babysit? I'll do that. You want me to dust? I'll do that. I'll walk your dog.
No, nothing. I have Bridget. I'm fine. Well, thank you.
What about heavy lifting?
No,
The laundry. I'll do it. I'll answer your call.
Victoria, it's Grant. What time do we leave?
Grant. He wants to know what time you two are leaving.
Hi. I'll be ready in about an hour, so why don't we just meet there, okay?
You know, you still haven't told me where we're going.
Right. Okay. Okay, we are going to the Corey cabin.
Sounds perfect.
Yeah, I can't wait either. Okay, I'll see you there.
No.
Okay. Bridget, put a couple more burgers on. Nick's gonna be staying. Thanks. Okay, bye-bye. You have a good night. I'll see you later.
Good try, Vic. Why don't you want me to know you're going to the Corey cabin with Grant? What is going on with you guys?
Okay, honey, now we have a lot to get this morning. What? Is it time?
No, I think we just should have had breakfast before we left the house.
Oh, yeah, I could eat.
Here.
Kellogg's Nutri-Grain Bars.
Low fat. I think it's great that you're eating healthy, but for me,
just try it.
Yeah?
Kellogg puts whole grain in the soft golden crust and luscious real fruit in the filling.
Mmm, I like it. You're gonna be good at this mom thing.
Yeah, I think I'm ready. I'm not ready.
Just breathe in.
Kellogg's Nutri-Grain Bars. Start your morning off right.
Why a kitchen made of glass? To clear up a point. For tough messes like this, you need new improved glass and surface Windex. See, the leading all-purpose cleaner can leave a cloudy residue. But glass and surface Windex cleans tough, greasy stains, leaving nothing behind but the shine. Just because your kitchen's not really made of glass doesn't mean it can't shine like it. Thanks to glass and surface Windex from SC Johnson Wax.
Is this getting serious?
I think so.
Well, how do you feel about it? Just imagine if you hadn't run out of coffee.
Just imagine if you hadn't had Taster's Choice.
Savor the sophisticated taste of Taster's Choice.
So tell me, Jeremy, how's your mother?
Dad, I think she's in love.
Really?
Nothing melts away the cold like a delicious hot bowl of Campbell's soup.
Let it snow, let it snow.
Campbell's makes everything better.
Hair with this much curl, this much body, and this much softness is now even easier to manage. The Perm Sale at JCPenney Styling Salons.
Kate, I thought you were home with a bad cold.
Oh, but now I feel better.
Did you take Sudafed for your stuffy nose, Chlortrimeton for sneezing?
I only took Comtrex.
Extra strength Tylenol for headache, Robitussin maximum strength for your cough?
For a cold, why take all these when Comtrex does it all?
You know, for somebody who doesn't like getting the third degree, you certainly know how to dish it out.
Come on, Vicky. Jake is convinced that Grant is nothing but bad news
Grant
for you.
Grant is the father of my youngest child. I have things to discuss with him.
Oh, all alone? In a cabin in the woods.
Okay, fine. You want to stay here? You can stay.
Yes.
It's okay. Okay,
yes.
Stop. I'll be right there. Now listen to me. Just keep your dog off my sofa.
No problem.
And keep your nose out of my business. All right,
okay.
I'm coming.
Okay.
And that includes don't tell Jake one
Jake,
word about where
Jake, Jake?
I am tonight. All right, not
no.
a word. Not anybody.
Gotcha.
All right?
Yes. Deal.
Deal. Deal. Okay,
yes.
Great. Great. Fine. Hi. Oh, so glad you're... Okay, give me the key.
No, I'm really going to miss that... cabin. Matthew was going to be taking me there for Valentine's Day.
Right. Well, just don't think about it. Don't think about it. Thank you. It's going to make you feel bad. So come on, I'll walk
it's
you out.
It's not. Well, you're going there now?
Or,
why on earth
or
did
not.
You want to
okay,
go?
Okay. Good night. Goodbye.
Bye.
So tell me, Laura, your suggestion is that the police department just turn the other cheek, right?
No, but your investigation is starting to scare the patients.
Well, you know something? If I were a patient in this hospital, I would be scared if there was an employee running around playing God.
Can you show me any evidence at all that a staff member here is responsible for the plug pullings of the life support systems?
No, I told you I don't have any evidence. Yeah.
Well, then why don't you go start catching the real criminals? Leave the BCGH staff alone. Gabe, I mean Captain McNamara.
Steven? I got your messages, all five of them. How can I help you?
Well, give me a minute. I'm sure I can think of something.
I've been working around the clock on this Maggie Corey murder case, which hardly means that the robbers and petty criminals have taken a vacation, so if you don't mind...
Well, that's exactly what I was telling Lieutenant Sinclair, that the police should stop wasting their time poking their noses into non-situations like the so-called... plug pullings here at BCGH.
Wait a minute. You took me away from my duties to try and derail my department's investigation?
No, I just thought that...
This situation is very real. Two patients have already died. And for your information, my officers are working under my direct orders and are doing so with the utmost professionalism.
Well, if you mean Watson Sinclair, Captain, I think you need a reality check. Now, Dr. Madison and I heard them arguing earlier, and it sure didn't sound friendly. And it sure as hell didn't sound professional.
Male-female relationships can be tricky.
Yep.
I take it things haven't improved between you and Josie?
No, sir. Things are getting worse by the day. Because she knows that I'm hiding something from her, and she's on a mission to figure out what it is.
That's why the regulations were put there, Gary, to prevent situations like this from occurring in the first place.
Well, you know something, sir? With all due respect to you, Josie is the woman that I was meant to be with. She knew it, I knew it, and your regulations never stood a chance. I mean, there was no way that we were going to give up our feelings for each other. And then, this Cobra came along.
Look, I wish I had more positive news. I've been calling in favors all down the line to try and get a beat on her whereabouts, but it seems as if this Cobra has just vanished.
Hi. Blair, right?
Yeah, I knew you couldn't want that much sugar in your coffee.
Yeah, I think I'm just a little distracted is all. So how are things at the Herald going?
Good.
Yeah?
They could be better.
Really? How so?
Are you really interested?
Sure.
Great, Josie, because I need a favor. A really big favor.
Has this ever happened to you? You color your hair, you love it. Then it can start to fade away. But now there's new fade-resistant preference by L'Oreal. So your color stays truer, longer.
New fade-resistant preference by L'Oreal.
We're worth it.
Looking for a good seal? Only one has the strength of Reynolds in a plastic wrap. Reynolds Plastic Wrap. It stretches to seal stronger, longer than any other premium wrap. Reynolds Plastic Wrap. Seals stronger, seals longer.
You're watching the amazing cleaning power of new Soft Scrub Gel. So powerful, it cleans this tough stain right before your eyes with no scrubbing. Then it rinses clean away. New Soft Scrub Gel.
Just look at me now, dear.
Hello, Marco.
Good afternoon, madame.
Hello, Marco. Smart Pop. 94% fat-free, 100% care-free. From Orville Redenbacher.
Tomorrow on Today, Dr. Art Yulin and his series Take It Off 1996. Find out how to party but without all the fat. Tune in tomorrow and see what a difference today makes.
Progresso reinvents chicken soup. Introducing Progresso white meat chicken soups. Made with only tender, luscious white meat. Only 100% seasoned white meat for an enticing flavor that gives each and every Progresso chicken recipe its own distinctive taste. Mmm. New Progresso white meat chicken soups. Unveiling a whole new way to enjoy chicken soup that's totally delicious. Totally Progresso.
And now, cooking with Chef Jim.
Today, I'm going to show you how to debone a chicken breast, season it perfectly, cut it into strips, and cook it just right. All in less than 5 seconds. You ready? It's our new Purdue Shortcuts. We've already done all the work. All you have to do is add it to your favorite dish. Whew. This cooking business sure is hard.
New Purdue Shortcuts Chicken. Look for all four in the fresh meat case.
This Valentine's Day, you can turn to 10 for Hearts in Bloom.
When I'm with you, you take me away.
I knew a woman who had so little real food in her refrigerator.
That's not true. My refrigerator isn't completely empty. I mean, I know I have a little leftover pasta somewhere.
Mmm, yum. And chocolate.
I've never seen so much chocolate. Why do you have so much chocolate in there?
Recovering alcoholic and all of that, you know, chocolate, caffeine.
Satisfies a craving, huh?
Yeah, something like that. And when that doesn't work, I run to the typewriter. That's my real life saver.
Did you ever want to be anything besides a writer?
Yeah, I mean, I've been a lot of things other than a writer. I owned a restaurant, and I now own a bookstore. I'm a real entrepreneur.
Okay. No. I mean, that part of you that is a writer, where did that come from? Come on, you have to tell me. Chocolate is a truth serum, you know?
Yeah, I've suspected that for a long time. Oh, thank you. All right, let's see. Well, I was a free spirit when I was very young. In fact, legend would have it that I wore a tutu to kindergarten. And I love playing dress up, and I always had my hands in finger paints.
Sounds like you were a real handful.
Let's see, I guess when I was around 5, it got to be a little too much for my stepfather. Well, I actually got to be a little too much for him. He didn't really see the poetry in me, as they say. You don't want to hear about it.
No, I do. I do, please. Go on.
Maybe it was because he didn't feel he was enough of a success or something. I don't really know what happened. Why he was so angry. He just was. Usually at me. At least he took it out on me. He used to take away my toys, said I didn't deserve them, and if I had a really pretty dress, he would make me sit there and watch while he cut it up with the scissors. Little girls weren't supposed to be so vain. I had this doll. I really loved her. She had this short, curly little hair, and she had blue eyes, and he thought I was too old to be playing with dolls, so he threw her out the window. I can still feel it. It was like he threw me out the window. I was the one falling.
When I was 16, I met Luke.
I was so starved for someone to see me and to just love me for who I was, and God bless Luke, he did. When I got pregnant with Lorna, I wasn't strong enough for my stepfather. He shut me away from everybody. And when I gave birth to her, he told me that she was dead. I never even got to hold her. I really thought God took her out of my life. I stood at the window at the hospital and it was raining outside, and I thought to myself, you are really all alone, Fanny.
So tell me, how did you ever get from that window to here?
Well. Hello, Felicia. You know, it wasn't easy going from Fanny Grady to Felicia Gallant. Believe me. I ran away from home. I took off. I went to Europe. I lived on the streets there, and an older man found me, and he really changed my life.
A lover?
Edward was a lover of literature and the arts. He was my mentor and my dear, dear friend. He really taught me so many things. Most of which was to embrace life, to expand.
experience it, his joys. I was never really allowed to grow up. He's the one that talked me into writing. And with his help, I literally recreated myself, Alicia Gallant. I believed it was a gift, the writing. All those fantasies that I dreamed about that my stepfather tried to destroy, they would come out on paper every time I would sit down to write something. Remember what you said about medicine being a calling? Well, that's how writing was for me. And I believed if I worked very hard and I got very good at it, that I could actually save other people and help them with their loneliness. Do you know that I never could write a word without wearing this around my neck? I don't know. Maybe now I finally outgrown it. We think we're so old, you know, when we're 18 or 21.
Yeah, we always think like we're all grown up. Nothing could be further from the truth. There is no resolution, is there?
The truth is...
What? Tell me what the truth is.
Truth is, we're still growing every day in here, in our hearts. We're still becoming what we really are for as long as we live.
I'm just starting to realize that.
Right on time, Grant.
Blindfold, monsieur?
No.
Cigarette?
No.
What do you want on your tombstone?
Pepperoni and cheese.
Tombstone pizza, Pierre!
Introducing new Tombstone French Bread Pepperoni Pizza. It's loaded with cheese. More cheese than even Stouffer's pepperoni. And that's good. What do you want on your tombstone? New French Bread Pizza.
Ask your dentist about Arm & Hammer Dental Care.
Our dentist gave us a reason to brush with Arm & Hammer Dental Care.
The reason? The baking soda.
2 out of 3 dentists recommend baking soda for healthy teeth and gums. And only Dental Care's patented formula gives you more than twice the baking soda of any other brand.
And more dentists recommend Arm & Hammer than any other baking soda toothpaste.
Arm & Hammer Dental Care. Serious care for healthy teeth and gums.
And try Arm & Hammer Antiperspirant, the only one with odor-eliminating baking soda.
If you're like me, you want a tampon with a cardboard applicator. But it's gotta be comfortable. Leave it to Playtex to give you comfort in cardboard. New Silk Line, with an improved applicator that's even easier to use. It just feels better. New Silk Line. Because Playtex is comfort.
Big news! Now Playtex has soft comfort tampons with their softest, most comfortable applicator ever. For extra comfortable protection, Playtex is comfort.
There's true romance on Days, but Another World sets a romantic trap, and Soap Opera Weekly has the stories. Plus, revealing interviews, behind-the-scenes scoops, and absolutely positively the latest news. Nobody knows the soaps like Soap Opera Weekly. Buy it today.
So full of life, save us.
Friday, NBC Arresting Television. First, Unsolved Mysteries. A stillborn baby beyond help. But 40 minutes later...
He has a heart rate. This baby's alive.
A real-life miracle. Then, an all-new Dateline. She suffered a brutal sexual attack. Now she's dedicated to keeping sexual predators behind bars. And Lily Tomlin.
I killed the one person I love most in this world.
A killer.
She escaped?
How the hell could you let this happen?
Track down an all-new homicide on Arresting Television, NBC Friday.
Hi. Gabe, I'm really sorry about that misunderstanding.
I didn't misunderstand a thing. The way I see it, you're trying to use whatever personal relationship we have to influence a criminal investigation.
Wait a minute, Captain. Don't go overboard here. We just happen to have a difference of opinion on...
I don't form my opinions until I have all the facts. You, on the other hand, seem to have absolutely nothing but doubts, perhaps based on the fact you're trying to hold on to your job.
That is not fair.
Look, you can try and stonewall my officers, but Watson and Sinclair are going to uncover the truth sooner or later.
Well, maybe it would help if they were working undercover. But they're still wearing those damn blue uniforms, and that's scaring the patients.
I'm sorry, I can't help that.
And it's not just the patients, it's the staff. They're starting to wonder what kind of a place they're working in with police hanging around all the time. Gabe, this hospital has not even recovered from the bad press from the Ben Michaels case, the bomb threats. As it is, I'm sitting here... looking at the hospital's records, and it's starting to hit the hospital's bottom line.
Well, my bottom line is that my department stays on this case until we find out who's pulling these plugs.
No, wait a minute. Whatever Bozo is doing this, the police are going to scare him off, and you're never going to catch him. What I think you need to do is...
Look, I am not interested. I am not interested in your advice.
Don't you care anything I have to say?
No. I just want you to do your job and leave me to do mine.
I knew it.
Gee, what are you doing here, Nick?
I'm just hanging out, man.
Oh, yeah? Well, where is she? Where's your lame brain sister?
How dare you, of all people, talk about Victoria like that?
I have no idea where she is.
Of course you do. She went to the Corey cabin, and in this weather, they probably have snow drips up to the...
Well, you know something? Maybe she took along something to keep her warm.
I gotta get to the church
right
now.
No, you don't. You can stay right here.
Blank?
No, I mean like a man.
No, she would have told me about that.
Look in the eye, and you level with me. Now, did Vicky go to the cabin with Grant?
Driving here, I kept imagining what you'd look like when you opened the door. But you're even more beautiful than I thought. What's the matter? What'd I say? Can I do anything?
No, really, you've already done too much. That's just the problem.
I don't understand.
I'm sorry. I've made a terrible mistake. I shouldn't have asked you to come up here. I need to get a hold of my feelings.
What feelings?
I've been very lonely.
I'm sure you have.
But I know that's no excuse for these dreams I've been having, and please don't even ask me, because I can't even look at you. I'm so embarrassed.
Look, you know you can confide anything
I know,
in me.
I know. The night when I had the flu and you came to take care of me. You know, it's just that Ryan has only been gone for a couple of months. And it's absolutely not like I've forgotten about him. It's just that somehow I've grown to care about you. Oh. You knew that, didn't you?
I've been afraid to hope. I felt disloyal to my brother.
Grant.
It's all right.
No, it's not all right. No, it is not. I mean, I should be mourning. You know, I shouldn't be spraying perfume on and spending hours in front of my closet trying to decide what I'm going to wear so that you'll think I look beautiful.
Well, I've always thought you look beautiful.
I tried to fight this. I really, really tried to fight this. But the night at the hospital, when you saved Stephen and Kirkland in the elevator and then you came back to save me, just haven't been able to think about anything else ever since.
We have gotten closer, haven't we?
Yeah. Like I knew you'd wear this tie.
You said you liked this tie at the Harbor Club.
I know. The night we had dinner. Grant, I'm sorry. I really am sorry. I don't even know how you can respect me.
No, I admire you more than any woman I've ever known. You're strong. You're tough. You're very giving. You're a wonderful mother to my son. I don't think there's any way that I... I love you, Victoria. And if there's the slightest possibility that you could ever return my love.
No, listen to me. I'm way ahead of you, Grant. At the hospital, in the elevator, when you came back to rescue me, when you risked your life for me, that's when I knew I loved you. It's just that...
What? Tell me, please. What?
Oh, I feel so drawn to you. I do. But I just don't feel that we can move on together. Well, I'm keeping this from you.
Keeping what? Tell me. Keeping what?
I know what really happened the night Ryan died. I know.
Unlike those big juice companies, we have a different idea about window offices, cutting overhead, even liquid assets. Florida's natural premium brand, not from concentrate juice, is made by a co-op of growers whose only business is making juices. They own the land, the trees, the company. So although our idea of market forecast may be a little different, it's a difference you can taste. Florida's natural premium brand juice.
You want the best for your kids. So when they have diarrhea, give them what pediatricians recommend most, Pedialyte. Unlike juice or sports drinks, which do not meet medical guidelines for helping prevent dehydration, Pedialyte is formulated with the correct balance of carbohydrate and electrolytes for quick absorption. Pedialyte. Don't your kids deserve the best? And now Pedialyte is available in a great-tasting new flavor, grape. The last ones left the house. It's just the two of you now. It's time for Create a Meal. It's a great meal without a big hassle. Brown your favorite meat, lay on a hearty measure of Green Giant's fresh-tasting veggies, our delicious Create a Meal sauce, and in 20 minutes, it's dinner the way it used to be. It's a fresh solution to dinner. Create a Meal.
Ho, ho, ho.
Green Giant.
Yo,
You'll get a great deal on a Kenmore refrigerator during the Sears National Home Appliance Sale.
I've been waiting for this.
Save $130 on a 19 cubic foot refrigerator with a free factory installed ice maker.
Really?
Or save $100 on a 20 cubic foot refrigerator.
Oh, that's the one I want.
Plus, when you use your Sears card, you get 0% finance charge on both.
0%?
No billing, no payments, no finance charge till April. Only at Sears Brand Central.
I can't wait to get there.
Which leading multivitamin is sodium-free with no added sugar or lactose and has the most beta-carotene? It's Geritol Complete.
You're kidding. Geritol?
And it has more vitamins and minerals than these.
I'm taking it.
Geritol Complete. Complete for what's in it, special for what's not.
Your mother-in-law is coming. She'll want to see that dress she gave Ellen. Don't risk it, whisk it with new whisk. In just one wash, whisk gets out tough stains. Don't risk it, whisk it with new whisk.
If this were one of your romance novels, and we were on the last page, tell me what would happen.
Well, the hero would sweep up the heroine and carry her away. I used to believe that that's what would happen in real life.
But what?
What you read on a page and you dream about.
Alicia, you write those words, don't you believe them?
Those are fantasies for somebody else, not for me.
Why can't you ask for what you want?
I'm afraid that...
What?
Whatever I care about, whoever I want, I'm afraid I'll lose them. Will you stay with me a while, John?
Josie, it really is fate, me running into you here. Because my plan is, I want to research and write an article about you.
Oh, about me? You're kidding, right?
No, really. I'll write this great profile about this rookie cop, and Matt will be so impressed, he'll put me on the writing staff.
You're not going to find anything interesting to write about me.
Are you kidding? What about the whole woman in a man's profession thing?
No. Don't even get me started. All that macho cop stuff is a crock, definitely.
Josie, if you'll let me write this article, I can start taking notes right now.
Sure. Well, why not? It'll be fun, right?
Great. I'm always prepared. Okay. About this male-female thing.
Mm-hmm.
Is it a problem for you on the force? I mean, do the men treat you like one of the guys?
Yeah, most of them do. There is this one guy, though.
And that is?
Oh, he was my instructor at the police academy, and now he's my superior officer. So he's sort of like always on your
case. He's overbearing, overprotective, and basically just full of it, if you know what I mean.
You know what? You know what? You know what happened on the trestle? You mean when Justine shot Ryan?
No. I know what really happened. Grant, listen to me. Now, I know how upset you've been since that night, and it has hurt me to see you carrying this around all by yourself. It's okay. I understand.
Victoria,
and I'm here for you. Listen to me. I'm here for you. Nothing's going to change the way I feel. I love you in spite of what happened, and I want you so much. But I don't feel that we can be together with this between us. You want me to, don't you?
Oh, so, yes.
Tell me. Just tell me what happened. What happened the night Ryan was killed, and then we'll never, ever have to mention it again. Okay, you can do that. For me, can't you? You can do it for us.
Oh, right. Yes.
A food bank.